Now sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
That's why she got there early in the morning. She tried to get John and the other disciples to go with her, and she outran them. Why was she outrunning them? She had to get there first to do something before they got there. She went on alone to the tomb to give him a proper burial, which consisted of placing coins in the eyes, anointment with herbs and oil, and wrapping the body, which according to Judaic customs, only a wife of close relative is allowed to see the body of the dead. Who was Mary Magdalene, and why was she concerned with Yahshua's, Jesus' body? Mary Magdalene was Yahshua's wife, and that is whose wedding was at Cana. Mary Magdalene means Mary of Magdala. The name Dala is derived from the Greek form Magdala, Magadan, meaning the tower or watchtower. Mary Magdalene was from the Tower of Magdala, located on the western shore of the Sea of Galilee, about 3 miles north of Tiberias. Mary Magdalene was considered an adulteress originally, but repented after meeting Yahshua, Jesus, for the first time. She was also the sister of Martha and Lazarus, John chapter 11 verse 2. This woman whose name is not given found out Yahshua's whereabouts and brought an alabaster box of ointment with her with the intentions of anointing Yahshua's, Jesus, feet. This was obviously not the first meeting, because she knew to bring her alabaster box of ointment. This woman was Mary Magdalene. The actions, the kissing and wiping of Yahshua's feet with her hair, of this woman that Yahshua led in the Pharisee's house, who he obviously knew was a sinner, started to cause doubt in the Pharisee's mind about Yahshua being a prophet, and Yahshua, Jesus, having more than a spiritual connection of forgiving her sins. Being a prophet, it would be unlawful for Yahshua, Jesus, to allow himself to be rubbed by a woman who was considered to be a sinner. Why Yahshua, observing the Pharisee's actions, spoke to them in parables. This parable is symbolic of the type of relationship Mary Magdalene and Yahshua had. Luke chapter 7 verses 40 to 50, washing and anointing, rubbing or wiping the feet with oil, is known to be a Judaic tradition. When Yahshua went to Bethany alone to Martha's house, Martha wanted Yahshua to make Mary help her serve. Yahshua spoke on behalf of Mary Magdalene. Luke chapter 10 verses 38 to 42. Next, she is mentioned with certain other women who had been delivered from evil spirits. All of these women being devoted by gratitude for their deliverance from sicknesses. Mary had 7 demons taken out of her. When Yahshua, Jesus, saw the sign of Lazarus, the brother of Mary Magdalene and Martha, death in a journey, he hurried back to Bethany, the home of Martha and Mary Magdalene. Before he went into the house, he sent for Mary Magdalene to privately meet him, John chapter 12 verses 1 to 3. 6 days before Passover, when again, Yahshua, Jesus, came to Bethany for a supper for Lazarus. Again, Mary of Magdalene took a pound of ointment of spikenard and lavishly rubbed his feet with costly oil. Mary Magdalene was at the so-called crucifixion. It was the first day of the week and the Sabbath had ended, where Mary Magdalene can be found going to the sepulchre to anoint the body of Yahshua. We must first see that in spite of her past life, Mary was one that had reformed to the ways of Hebraic law, because she waited until the Sabbath had ended to go to the sepulchre where she thought Yahshua laid again. Next, let us understand that only the wife or the mother can anoint the body of the dead or see the family member's naked body. People don't think about or even consider questioning little points like this because they're afraid they would be doubting the Most High's word. Muslims such as Ahmed Didat are under the assumption that Mary knew Jesus was alive, therefore she was looking for a live Jesus, not a dead one, based on the quote in the Quran stating that Yahshua, Jesus, did not die.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.